Can you see the shoes? And I do my own laundry. Do my own laundry and shit. I guess you can just call this Big Kev Competent Cooking 101.
Yeah, that's me. That's it. Fucked up something.
Oh man, I've been cooking everything. I got a whole little portfolio of shit that I've done cooked on my own. On my Facebook page. I just create shit with the cabbage and stuff like that. Let me get some background music on in this thing. Anybody investigating it, that was a crying damn shame. Only what the label like to get you in the business. Gracias, mi amigo. Amiga.
Some cutting. Prep my skillet. Put a little grease in there for the cookery that's about to be going on.
Cut my cabbage up while you're here, too big to fit in the fridge. I need an onion. That's a big old cut. Thank you.
Switch counters. What a light it in here. That's not it. And this is also something pretty magnificent, if you will. Because some people don't like a whole lot of potatoes and stuff. Some people can't eat potatoes at all. But you know what Kevin Graham figured out? You can still have yourself hash browns or hash greens. But they be brown on this one. I need my honey from there. Hey, Big Kev back up in the house. Shout out to my kinfolk for making this episode of Big Kev Cooks, you know, possible. Cooking in a nice kitchen for the past couple weeks, you know what I'm saying? One thing I think about, no matter how I be feeling sometimes, didn't have to say yeah. I'm trying to push it on down the road somewhere. I be trying to work my way through certain things, but it's all up to you. Careful trying to cut. It's awkward for me. Most of the time I cut stuff in my hand. So I'm trying to use a cutting board to be like, ugh. I know it seems silly, right? You're thinking, after a while you get used to the way you do something. I'm trying not to cut my goddamn finger. Step one, cabbage, right? Step two, onion. All right, cut the onion up. You're doing just like hash brown. No, hash brown, potatoes. Cook them too, but, you know. I try to add, my best rule of thumb of eat like you already when you try not to be, you know what I'm saying? the way I put my oil in there. Alright. I gotta move this damn thing. I'm gonna take my laptop off. Onions in there off the board. Cut hair, cut cabbage. You know what I'm saying? This one of them fancy ovens. Like I heard somebody talking about one not too long ago. Like it's got the top on it with no flame, but if you move the skillet, it'll make it go out. So you just gotta do it the best way you can. That's the way to test to see if your skillet done got hot at all yet. There's a little water. I'm being rather clumsy, but I'm getting, I bet you by the time this video's over, it'll have me a plate of food, goddamn. And all my, hopefully all my fingers. Probably change people's lives right there. Cabbage is very would the word be malleable? Make it into what you want it to be. Make cabbage noodles and things like that. That shit is really changing the game. Like this, that's the best veggie to substitute for all the things that you want it to be. You know what I'm saying? Let's put my face in this so I don't look at somebody else. I just do things a different way and it works out good. Other folks try to take credit from it. Or whatever. garlic powder in that drink. You use as much garlic powder as you want, but not as much garlic salt as you want. You know what I mean? Garlic powder is just garlic. You need a whole, you know, clove of garlic. You better not have no more than a fucking teaspoon, a fourth of a teaspoon of salt, a half a teaspoon. I'm thinking of that.
I do need a little bit.
I got some salt downstairs. I just brought it up. Black pepper, black pepper. I cooked this shit the other day. It was so goddamn good. I wanted to come home and cook some more of it. Well, I shit you not. Put a little bacon in there. It could be vegan, other than I like bacon. Today. The other day I cooked the eggs first, but this is the stuff for the omelet too, the omelet that I'll be making. Otherwise you just make it into hash brown. Cook all the green shit until it's brown. So the Big Kev cooks. Gonna have us a fine omelet with my own personal stuffing. Maybe some grits. You know what I'm saying? I use instant grits, but as long as they're gritty enough, that's all that matters. Cut me up some hot dogs on the side. Make the feet.
taking a long time. We have 20 minutes already. I guess it's better to have more footage than you need for the cutting room floor, if you will. Dang, I gotta get better about while cooking. Cleaning up while you're doing it. That room is somebody else's stuff. Hey, scattered and smothered. How y'all want them? No, it's smothered and covered. Yeah, hash brown. Smothered and covered. That just means cheese, I think, and gravy sometimes. Let you see how brown this is. Smothered and covered. I'm gonna put that there for now for safekeeping. I feel that heat on my face. Oh shit. Hotter, dude. Click
the link or visit Ashley.com to shop and save today and see why Ashley is America's number one furniture and mattress store. Ashley.
Hi, my name is Elise Fox, model, mom, and entrepreneur based in New York. I started my company Sad Girls Club on Squarespace in 2017 after using my passion for film to share my experiences with mental health. My Squarespace website helps keep my community in the know. Members can donate directly to Sad Girls Club, purchase our merch, and even subscribe to our monthly newsletter. There is so much more to come in 2023, so stay tuned and check out.
Yeah, what a fine goddamn. I'm gonna let you keep talking on there. And by the way, I'm currently at my cousin's, and his mother is my dad's twin sister. Ain't that something? I don't think I shared that with the viewing audience. Milton and Hilda Graham. Now,
One thing my dad told me when I was younger was that I've never been able to bust eggs like that. And I would just take them and bust them on the counter one shot like this. That's like a little, you like a little young cook. My pop said, I've never been able to bust an egg like that. You know another way you can bust eggs though? One egg always bust the other. I put five. God damn, I'm about to make an omelet though, ain't I? And the omelet don't make you no more than 3 eggs for an omelet. This is my own personal omelet. You do with your omelet how you will. Skillet get too cold. All right, I got some eggs in there from omelet. Add me a little salt. And be very careful when you're just using the fucking container because that should go fast. That's some pepper. I just had it. Presentation's sake, and the black pepper. Blue? Black pepper? I shouldn't put no black pepper though, because for the yellowest egg presentation you can have, it's best not to have no, coming up. I didn't see unhealed up that much, but I seen her every now and again she come down. More than likely, whenever I would look around and somebody be in Ann's room, it'd be Aunt May Laws.
Hey, man.
Yeah, she sound like this.
You guys.
That's how you know they from up north.
You guys doing down here?
That's Henry Bell, though.
Alright, oh, let's zoom back in over this way while I'm about to make hopefully a good looking omelet.
I shouldn't use all this egg. Now, I'm using a bigger skillet than I would want to normally. You got a big ass skillet, you gotta kind of work your omelet back into omelet shape. And that's not me being funny, that's just what you have to do. I normally don't use 5 eggs for an omelet, but you still gotta pull it back to the center. Pull it back to the center. This is just me being creative right here. I used too many eggs for the omelet that time. I
to do that. Like Steve Urkel.
And I do that.
On the truck, I took got to flipping them so good, I thought flipping them without the goddamn special. Boom! Woo! Man, it's done. Once you get that motherfucker to flip over, so it can cook, and you know, seal up. That's all it takes right there. 5 eggs. I normally don't use 5 eggs. I did that time. I need to stop cooking this thing. Bleep, right there. Put your little fillings inside your omelet. And then you close the omelet. Big Kev, 5 egg omelet.
Like hot dogs, cause if you, when you cooking breakfast, you just want some meat on the side. That's not really old reliable. Though.
Simple part or whatever, but if you don't do them right, they still taste like crap. You gotta put just a little bit of water in there, just a little, just, you gotta put it just right. You don't want it too runny, you know what I'm saying? Just barely cover up your grits. This is the easy part. This is the cheat and cook.
Look at it in about 3 minutes.
It's like I walked into this truck stop down around just south of Jackson one day. Went in there. Woman had a whole bunch of them up above the grill. I'm like, I see somebody else in there cheating too, huh? So you get the grits, man. How well you feel about yourself, how well you are get along with others, and how well you take care of your daily basic necessities of life or whatever. That's what mental health is. And as you can see, today I got up, took me a shower, dressed myself fabulously, just in my own clothes. And now I'm up in here cooking fucking breakfast that'll make a chef mad, because I saw one get mad because he couldn't make an omelet one day. Or he was mad that I could. Now, this is not the best presentation, but I used 5 eggs when I only should have used 3. But if I scrambled it though, I was going to cook 5. But for the best omelet presentation, you just want to use like 3 eggs. Now I'm scorching my hot dog wieners, because that's the way I like them. Them brown on both sides. Oh shit. And you also got to see me how I make my insides in my fucking arms. I did that. I do that. Hot dog up. Hot dog coming up. can make use if you damn man. If you like me, you make use of everything you can. Try to anyway. It's really still hot as shit right now, right? You know what? You want yourself some toast, you know what you're doing, you're still still hot? Grab you a couple pieces of bread, put it in there. Blue. This is breakfast, Kevin Graham style. I hope I ain't messing nothing up. They can't be, you know, easily wiped down. Some people wouldn't, I don't know. I'm damn sure about to. Grits, eggs, omelets, my insides on there. That plate ain't too hard, is it? That's it. Can you see it? Can you see that? Stuffed omelet, grits, wieners, toast, magnifique. It took a long goddamn time, just did. But that's a 5-egg omelet too. I don't think I ought to sit it on the table just yet. I'm trying to mess up, man. Anyway, I'm out. I'm gonna take a few pictures of it. But this has been Chef Kev. Do it the way you want to breakfast. You know what I'm saying? Maybe you want weenies with your breakfast. Maybe you like instant grits in the microwave, son. And a 5-egg omelet.
There you go. Bon appetit. I might put some, I love putting fucking herdies on everything. I had some in my room. I don't know if I'm going to go through with it or not. Anyway, I'm out. Take some steel pictures. 47 minutes. This completes a KG 2023 presentation of Big Kev Cooks Chefs It Up in the Kitchen. Bon appetit.